Hello everybody, Presented here, NecroDancer, daily challenge, let's get into it. Let's do a better job than yesterday. Quartz armor is a pretty good start. I think it is kind of very good. Maybe I overrate it, but I think it's pretty dang good. So you know what? Give me a reason not to like it so much and I'll think about it, but I'm pretty sure it's very, very good. Anyways, what am I trying to do on this run? I have to think about what happened on the last run and what I can do to be better. What's in here? Nothing. I was kind of actually hoping for a trap room for once so that I could be able to I could be able to get the barrel dealt with. This is a very strange placement for a mini boss room. Shit. All these are actually pretty good. Let's open up the shop. Also, a very strange place for the shop. Very, very weird. Normally, the mini-boss isn't, like, tucked away like that. Now that I might be able to get the barrel down to that bomb trap, perhaps? Let's give it a shot. Down. Okay, go down. Now, go this way. Oh god, I don't think I have enough time. You know what? Let's not worry about it. I'll never be able to see. Okay, so I have, this is a must. This is like a secondary must. And even though I feel like I can use the torch, I'm not gonna take it. I will spend 100 gold to ensure my ability to, let's try it, my ability to break open rocks. Okay, I do want to go this way. I'm gonna try it, you know what? Screw you, I'm doing it. Oh, this isn't gonna actually do it. I goofed, unless I somehow moved the barrel at the same time that the bomb trap was active. Oh, am I gonna make it? Yes, the blue slime has put himself in a position where he allowed me to move through him. There was a monkey next to the door. Thankfully, he just decided to die instantly when I opened the door by running into the rat like a big old silly boy. Oh, idiot. Oh, why did I do that? And I wasn't thinking, and now I'm getting the consequences of being stupid. With one heart, I could actually theoretically die in one hit, so I gotta be careful about that. Okay, I could use some heals. Okay, do I want to kill the shopkeeper? It's a possibility. I don't, actually. None of that is good. Wow. None of that is good or useful to me at the present. Anything in here, though? Ooh, a white chest. I can probably, yeah, do that. Get him hit by the rat. Let's open up that. I don't want to have to deal with the bomb trap. And I actually sort of have to be cautious because I could die easily, actually. I'm going to do my due diligence and open up that crate. Can I get an obsidian shovel? I cannot. I don't know what the that question mark thing does. I got it before, and it gave me like a weird weapon. Oh, that's very good, actually. It gave me a very strange weapon that I didn't really know what it did. It was like a weird amalgamation of... It was an amalgamation of, like, the rapier and the staff. It was very interesting. It might just be just that, like, where it gives you that specific weapon. Or it could just give you, like, the attributes of multiple weapons. And it's just random which ones it chooses. Okay, so with that, I got a gold weapon. Gold weapon's going to ensure my victory should I survive long enough to make it useful. I don't even want to pick up that spell, because I feel like I'm not going to use it how it should be used, and I feel like I'm just going to trap myself and then get killed. Oh, I was really hoping that would be a food product of some variety. And I did take the Nazar charm because even though, I mean, I say this every time I pick it up, but even though it does make me lose gold by not spawning enemies that drop gold, I feel like the benefit you get from not having to worry about those specific enemies is worth it. I will activate this for the... Actually, no, I won't. Now... Can the dragon bust through it? I don't think he can. I can try. You know what? Just... Here we go. How about that? Alright. I can bomb it for a treasure map. I think it's worth it. There we go. I'm pretty sure that this is definitely worth it. I could have activated it for an obsidian shovel, but... I don't think that I wanted that because the Shovel of Strength is actually very... Why did I do that? Is very good. Oh, idiot. I was trying to get the gold without getting the damn... To get the crate, I mean. Ah, screw it. There's probably nothing good in it anyway. If there was, like, a fucking Charm of Gluttony or something, I'd be pissed off. I was thinking, would the Rat Familiar hit the drums when they spawned? And now that I have a gold weapon, all I really care about now is like a heal spell or food. I'm gonna try for the heal. Ring of Frost is very good. And if I'm able to make this run work, okay, that's basically just an apple. I already got the map, so it's not the best, but it's still healing. Also, my fucking cats are making a lot of noise. I tried to get him out of the room, but I felt bad when he... I felt bad when... Because I took him, I picked him up, I brought him to the kitchen so that I could put him on the table, because he likes being on the table. I put him on the table and I'm like, here, just be here while I'm recording, alright? So you're not doing any sort of shenanigans. But as I'm walking back to my room, he also walks with me, and then I felt bad because I didn't want to force him out of my room when he wanted to be in, and so I gave in. I'm like, alright, you know what? You can be in my room then. There is not enough room to make me feel like getting the leprechaun is worth it. So you know what? We're just gonna have to wait on that. Thank you, Ring of Frost, for being, like, immensely good. So you're gonna go down. I should have used some of my bombs on the shop. Now there is something, yeah, oh my freaking Christ. Now I kinda I have 9. 9 is not the point of no return for bombs. So I don't have to worry about them yet. Ooh, that could have been bad. And another bad thing is I don't want to go into this shop because I'll have to use a bomb to get in, which will make me lose precious, precious gold. A pickaxe is good, but it's not useful now. I think the torch or the shovel of strength kind of beats any other shovel, except maybe the blood shovel on daily runs. What do we got here? Is that enough gold? It is. Nope, don't do it. I fucked up because that bomb trap kind of screwed me. Is that enough? Okay, yeah, do it here. Oh, he is frozen forever. Now, don't make him disappear like you did last time. Just get him all the way over here. Don't fuck with it, just kill him. That was a lot of gold, so you know what? No matter what happens, I'm glad I was able to get the leprechaun that low. And I think there's a case to be made to use a bomb here to get some of these bad boys. I can only get two at a time, so I'm gonna do those two. Okay, I got my bomb back, so you know what? Ring of Might. Oh shit. I think you take it. 3 damage is... So, I think 3... Wait, is it 4 damage? Wait, was I doing 4 damage? What was that? This could be a food shop. I'm gonna pass it up. Oh, there's a purple slime there, and he gave it up. No, it's 3 damage. So, of course, the shopkeeper ghost. But yeah, the 3 damage is a threshold I like to pass, because 2 damage is really good because it doubles your damage output from where you start. But 3 damage... Oh, I could have gotten hit there. 3 damage does allow you to start breaking things like crates and chests. And then 3 damage is also the threshold where many enemies die in at least 2 hits. Because 2 damage, it's not uncommon to see... Thankfully, he doesn't fall. Many enemies can die in 3 hits when you have 2 damage, but you can get most enemies in 2 with 3 damage. Just come here, come on. I think we're all done with your fucking nonsense. It was hard to think, it was hard to move to the beat with this fucking shopkeeper bullshit. And he's left. A tiny mushroom has gone in the Minotaur's way of getting to me. Yeah, that's like the only dude that... Why so many swamp beasts? That big golem dude is the only guy that really doesn't get killed in under 2 hits or under. Anyways, I've said my piece on 3 damage. Hopefully it was coherent enough to understand. The shopkeeper ghost was making it hard to both move to the beat, to talk coherently, and to focus on killing him when he starts moving towards me. Okay, let's get out of this hellhole. Yeah, that whole, like, weird shit with the rat familiar is very confusing, and I'm glad I was able to not make the king do some weird teleporting shit. That's not good. That's not good at all, my friend. Alright, let's go. Yeah, and also those black skeletons die in one hit, which is another major plus. Because those guys are especially annoying because, you know, you have to do enough damage so that they don't go all headless on you. Okay, with Bomb Spell, I do want to focus on getting to the shop, which doesn't look like it's gonna happen. Ooh, what the fuck happened there? But get here first. Can you just chill, alright? I have way too many bombs. The game keeps giving me more. And with the bomb spell, that's a little crazy. I could bomb that glass shrine for glass armor, but I don't think it's worth it. Oh, idiot, I didn't think about the fact that I had the broadsword, and I was like, I'm just gonna move on top of him, and the rat's gonna deal damage, but with the broadsword, dummy, you can't really do that, because you attack enemies in a wide angle. Okay, there we go. Looking good. No shrines yet. No, arena shrine from the looks of it. Oh, going on a journey. Oh, that was not good. But I got through it. I will. I want to save one of the corners for Bomb Spell. Because it's a waste if you don't use it when it's charged. And Bomb Spell could be the difference between placements, because if you use it enough, it could get you, it could net you hundreds of gold, which, oh, why did I do that, you dirty, dummy, dangler, idiot. Anyways, you know, I can use it, I've already used it twice right now, so that's 200 gold. Every use is 100 gold, at best. And so if you use it, you know, 10 times a run, that's 1,000 gold. That could really put you over the top. I kind of need to eat the ham also, because, like, I can theoretically die in one hit from a typical enemy. So I'm against my better judgment, I ate the ham, okay? I hate doing it, but desperate times call for desperate fucking measures. Arena, it is. What do we got? Oh, you know I want that. Oh, idiot, the fucking wide angle nonsense. Anyways. Get that multiplier back up. I want courage. The one thing I hate is it's not as useful because you get minus damage. Or it doesn't give you damage anymore. Oh, I can't. What am I? Why do I think I have the fucking, the axe? Okay, get rid of the damn courage ring, because you just screwed yourself, basically. Thankfully, I didn't straight up die. That would have been not good and very sad. Okay. And actually, now that I think about it, okay, I gotta kill this guy for the gold, even though I didn't have the multiplier. That's not good, so let's just leave. Oh, that barrel, though! No. You don't understand. No, it's so far away! I didn't make it. Oh my god, really, with the Yetis. Did not mean to do that. Let's just think about this for a second. All right, hold on. Gotta use bomb spell. That's the first step. There we go. Okay, now I'm good. Now you can fucking do whatever you want. All right, go over here, get these enemies, because the mini boss is on the other side. But yeah, I don't know if I articulated it well enough, but I should have used or activated the Shrine of Space, because even though I didn't want the obsidian shovel, it would have spawned more enemies as a result of the longer floor size. What a dragon is that? Don't be an ice dragon. Holy fucking shit, look at all them enemies. Here we go. It is an ice dragon, so I'm gonna sort of try my best to zone him out. There we go. That could have been bad, but we fixed it. Why so many Yetos? Oh, I don't have a x3 level shovel yet, dummy. There we go. Fuck the gold. I gotta focus on the Yetis. Oh god, okay, that was close. I don't know why I got so scared, but I did. More bombs, hooray! Monkey's Paw is actually very useful. More useful than I would admit, initially. There's gold here, I do want it. But I'm treading on very thin ice here. Pun intended, but still. This is serious. I could die at any moment if I don't play my cards right. These fucking... Okay, just... Oh, I almost went the wrong way. We did it though. I really could use a heal spell, please. You motherfucker. You think this is a game? You think this game I'm playing is a game? I don't think so, my friend. Thankfully. What the hell? Which cat was meowing? Was it my Pawsworth baby? What is wrong, little Paws? He never meows unless something is wrong. Okay. Please. Brace it. Embrace me with a fresh gold weapon that I can use other than this shitty damn broadsword. It's not bad, because it deals 3 damage, but still, it's like... Oh, why did I get so scared? Nah. So I'm still not entirely sure what's up with this Iron Maiden. I don't recall... being able to walk into them. I could be incorrect though. Also, I like how the Rat Familiar kills. It's basically Pierce. It pierces through the enemy's health. You god send. Do you hear all these fucking sentries going ape shit over there? What the fuck is going on? They're losing their damn minds. They're like screaming and then hitting into walls. It's fucking hilarious. Also, I kind of fucked the bomb spell, but holy shit, I have so many bombs. This is ridiculous. Also, fuck it, I'm gonna go up to the sarcophagus because I need that, the good sarcophagi gold. There we go. Okay. Okay, now what do I use Fireball for? I guess I can use it in a sort of last ditch effort if I need to like kill a mini boss or boss quickly, because it deals, I think it's an increased Fireball, so it deals like 5 damage. I think that's how it works. Thank you, Monkey Paw, also for screwing the damn monkeys into your perpetual freeze. Ooh, baby. No. You're an idiot. I was about to say your confusion doesn't confuse me, but I got hit because I used the wrong movement pattern. Movement input. What mini boss is it? Okay, careful with that guy, because I don't want to lose out. You bastardo! There we go. I lost out on some gold, but not all of it. Come on, really? What mini boss is it? There we go. Why is it that some mini bosses get aggroed like immediately from far away, but then like people like this dude? I missed the beat because I was like, wait, am I gonna kill him? And guess what? My hesitation has cost me my coin multiplier. Thank you for the gold though. Ooh, what do we got here? Yes, I think it's better. I would like my multiplier before I... Oh, idiot, what have I done? Did I at least get the gold? Did I at least get the gold? That's what I'm most concerned with. Okay, go into the shop. No, kill it! No, I can't kill it yet. Go back up. There's more enemies here. Oh, there's one more enemy? So I have to do this right. I have to kill the mage, hope that it gives me the multiplier, and then kill the sarcophagus before it can spawn another enemy. Alright, I got this. It was not enough. I tried my damnedest. Why did I do that? My brain read down left on the bombs and up right on the bomb spell, so I like combined them and hit down right. So stupid. So, you know, I say to myself, this is the run that's gonna put me in like the top 10, and then I make the stupidest mistakes. Whoa. And I'm like, you know what, maybe I don't deserve the placement that I feel like I deserve. Food. Yes! It is food! I appreciate it. Even if it's just... No, the gold! He came out of nowhere! Get him. He did this. The armadillo did this. He's behind the entire operation. You almost snuck up behind me while the dragon was gonna fiddle my diddle. You know what? No. This is the one. This guy right here. This. That sentry was the one that I was gonna redeem myself with, and it totally was. There's a dude here, right there. And thankfully, I have been able to use all of my bombs in a very good manner. Let's forsake this area a little bit. Come up here. There we go. I got all of that delicious gold. Nah, I actually think the courage shovel is trash, because you do need to use the shovel to dig buffer. If you can't dig buffer, how the hell are you supposed to buffer? I just don't get it. Don't hit him. He's going to teleport you. I do not wish to do that. Ooh, there we go. No, get away from me. Get away from me! Now you can... You can come closer. And as long as I keep this up, I might be able to get a very good score, because I'm already at 1,200. Oh god, get out. Just leave. There we go. That was a little finicky, but I did it. Again, a heal spell would negate any fears, but unfortunately, it didn't happen. This is the one of the few runs where I don't actually have... flying boots. Oh, you confused the absolute bollocks off of my butt. I don't want that. And here's Monkey Paw kind of showing its usefulness in that the water dudes were frozen. I don't want to backtrack too much, so I am going to go through the room here first. Also, Medusas are frozen, which is amazing. Because the gold ones are quite irritating. So it's good to have... It's good to have the Monkey Paw in that situation. This room is chock full of baddies. Why did I do that? I'm throwing! Okay. Lots of gold. Not a lot of consumables, might I point out. In this entire run, there haven't really been a lot of, like, food stuffs. There's been, like, you know, I think, like, one ham, which is very good if say... You didn't have, you know, you had more than 3 fucking health this entire goddamn run. But unfortunately, ham's not very useful when you have base health through the entirety of the run. Okay, let's go back to the shop very quickly, because I do have bomb spell ready to go. I've sort of been... surviving off the skin of my teeth. The very, like, 2 carrots and, like, 1 ham this entire run. It's been very, very scary. But I have 14,000 gold, so if I make it through the entirety of the game, I'm gonna have quite a bit of good stuff here. And yeah, 2 Medusers. 120 gold right there, boys. I just gotta knock him away, yeah, to reveal the legend of the treasure of the hidden temple. Gold rapier! Nah. One can only dream for such a high class weapon. What am I doing here? What am I doing here? Come on. Is that a mimic? Did I see you bounce up and down? Oh shit! I did. A bomb. You know what? That's 100 gold. You are of no use to me anymore, Mr. Shrine. I've been to the arena. That's about it. Don't kill any more enemies. No. Use this first. There we go. Now you can kill to your heart's desire. Yeah, I do like how the rat familiar is a piercing familiar, because you don't realize how useful that is until it, like, kills armadillos in one hit. It kills the the devils without popping them in their, like, moving once a beat form. It's just very, very nice. What is... Yeah, I was like, what is blocking your path? Oh, this guy's taking a weird path. He went, like, down and then all the way back around. It was very interesting to watch. Oh, there's a fucking gold bit over here. I gotta get it. It's like, what, 100 gold, I think? Right here. It's definitely worth it. No, it's 50. My bad. It's still worth it to a lesser extent, but it's still pretty much worth it. Just be very, yeah, aware of the enemies. Heal. Heal! You fuckers. Well, the shop's all the way down there. I don't want to backtrack, but also, I don't want to kill these enemies just yet. I'll kill only what's needed, which are, like, unfortunately, almost all of these enemies. The zombie I killed because he's annoying. That also might count as a kill, getting the Medusa. Or it might count as a kill when you, like, pop it. Oh, that does not count as a kill. I think it only counts as a kill when you, kill it initially. I still want to know if there's, like, a way to kill those stone Medusas once they're in, like, stone form. And I'm gonna hold on to the ham. If I get hit once, I have to pop it, basically. Holy shit, that was very good electrification. And I do have bomb spell again. I basically have to use it now because this is the last level, dude. Last chance. I don't think I'm gonna be able to use it again, but being able to use it, that was what, like 5 or 6 times? Maybe 5. That's still 500 gold. Oh god, you are a scary dude. There we go, he has been defeated. And I think my play during this run's actually been relatively decent. I haven't made that many mistakes on Zone 5. Zone 4, I made a little bit more mistakes, but not to the extent that I typically do. I don't want to transmogrify. Alright, let's just go. I do want him to not ring a bell just yet. Oh god, I forgot he can move diagonally. That scared the poopy out of my poop. Just come this way, alright? I'll dictate when it's acceptable to ring a bell, okay? Don't you ring? No! How dare you! You do not spawn enemies that have already spawned, you bastardo. Get over here, alright? You're coming this way. Do not ring that bell just yet. There we go. Up, 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 up. I have done it. I don't even care about those chests. If I win, oh my god, can I surpass 2,000? No, I don't think I have enough. Unfortunately, I think I'm gonna get close, but I don't think I'm gonna be able to do it. I gotta do some little fucky here, right? No, don't do that. I gotta go all the way over here. Do that. One more up, though. Ooh, I can pop that. I can also kill these guys. How about this guy? Yeah! Yeah! Very nice. Okay, well, I gotta use this, because the game hates me! Puts the buttons in the weirdest combinations. One more up should do it. Now, he's gonna start spawning very strong enemies now, which is gonna be fucking annoying, of course. I want to keep the longsword, actually. You killed him! You murdered your own! Monster! Oh god. No, you don't understand. I don't wish to die now. Okay. Attack him. I wish to attack. Nope. Just kidding, I don't want to attack him. What the fuck? Why do you run? Oh! I was like, I can hit him with both of my characters. But I did not deal enough damage to moiter him. I thought I did damage to him, but it could have been another Minotaur. Damn! Ah, I'm so mad. If I won, that would have put me all the way in 8th place. Shit. I am not happy. I'm not happy with that ending. Damn it. You lose all your damage when you get the loot because it's so powerful. Anyways. I just didn't focus enough. I should have focused a little bit more on the final fight. I did very well up to that point. Zone 5, I think that's some of the best play I've had in Zone 5 for a while. I didn't take a lot of damage. I maximized gold. I ended Zone 5 with like 18,000 gold, so that's very good considering I typically only get about 14,000 at the end of the game without a gold weapon, so that gold broadsword really pushed me through. But yeah, 11th place honestly isn't that bad. It's probably gonna bump down to like top 20 by the end of the day, so that's a little unfortunate, but I'm still happy with, for the most part, how that run turned out. Anyways, actually, it was better than yesterday's run, raw score-wise, but I feel like that ending play was a lot worse. But anyways, yeah, that's about it. That run was still fun. You don't get a lot of gold weapons occasionally. The fact that it was a broadsword kind of ruined it a little bit, but It was a good gold weapon run, nonetheless, and I very much enjoyed it, despite the ending. And I hope you enjoyed it too. If you did, please show your appreciation by liking, commenting, subscribing, all that garbage, and I'll see you guys next time.